I am in the process of trimming it down evenly. Cutting all the uneven edges. Balancing it out. Since I cut off all the tabs, That's the process. Harbor Freight Mini Lathe. I'm using spacers because I could not angle it properly for the right distance. So I'm going to be making a jig that will go on here so I can have an L-shape mount clamp. So I can put the bits in any position for the angle needed. There's a will. There's a way. And I have a bit coming off the other side that's not being used except for a support. Just to get this in the right angle. Another typical engineering issue that needs to be changed. People just can't make things correctly, so I have to make it on my own. So I'm going to make a tool that I can put my bit in any position to do the clamping so the support right here does not run into the thing being cut. The way they have it set up, you can only work with small stuff, and I needed to work with something bigger, and I was limited on the distance of the tool and the base running into the part. There's a will, there's a way. This side doesn't look that bad. I trimmed it up a little bit. Took off the high spots. Working on the magnet motor. This is what was energized right here. That energized the... These were electromagnets sticking out. We're going to go permanent magnets. And you can see the plastic right there as a barrier between the sides. So one side's positive, one side's negative. What I believe, I'm not an expert on this setup, but unless they're all equal, I'm not a alternator specialist, but whatever it was, positive or negative, it's going to have positive and negative neodymium magnets. I did not look up on the internet to find out what side's positive, one side's negative, or are they all positive or all negative. I'm not too sure. I did do my homework on that. My goal was to cut them off because right now the wire has been snipped, as you can see. Gone. And on this side, gone. So this is useless right now, except for we need just the bearing. And this part I didn't take off I didn't want to take the bearing off. I wanted to leave it in position, so I just remove the plate and let it flop around in there while I'm doing the work. That's why I didn't want to go super high speed. That's the status. Can't wait to get it working. Hopefully it has thick enough coils to produce enough energy what I want. Gotta clean it up. It's dirty. What do you expect when it came from a shop that's just laying all over the floor? This is one of their garbage ones. Looks like it's been in an off-road vehicle the way it looks. Alright, that's the status. Garbage electronics. We're not using anything except for the case. All this is gone. This is gone. Keeper, and the screws. And bolts.